Your master, Hazur Baba Sawan Singh, is commonly referred to as Great Master. How did he come to be called Great Master?
I think he should have been called the Greatest Master. I call him the Greatest Master. He's called Great Master because of various things. One, his style of delivering the message, spiritual message, was so direct that you could feel he's speaking from Sajkhand and not speaking from what he had learned from the books. His reference to books was only for the scholar sitting there. And he was talking directly from the experiences. And this is a great sign of a great master, that when he talks, he doesn't give the impression he's talking from some books he has learned from. He's talking from his experience. Great master gave that impression to everybody who listened to him. And it was great, with authority. Actually, if you see in the Bible, when Jesus Christ gave his sermon on the mount, at the end it says, there was a hush upon the multitude, for he spake like one with authority and not like the scribes. It's a true sign. One who is speaking with true knowledge does not need to have memories of something that he saw or memories of what he read. It's direct experiences these people are having. So that is why he never used any notes for discourses. He never referred to anything else for telling people. He never took time to answer their questions. They came directly from his knowing. And that is why he was called Great Master, recognized. And when we went to other masters, we saw many masters. I have seen so many in my life, all over the world, seen masters. They read, they tell where to read more. They tell you how to do things. And then they say, I did this sometime long ago. So there's a big difference in the authority with which a perfect living master speaks. And he spoke with such authority that everybody started calling him Great Master. So I call him the Greatest Master.